Today we are going to cover current affairs for 6th October. So the most important news item that has been covered on 6th October is the governance reforms panel that was created by SEBI and headed by Mr. Uday Kotak. So the recommendations of this 25-member SEBI panel become very important for RBI examination 2018, especially for finance section. So first of all, we are going to talk about the summary of the recommendations, and then we are going to look at the pictures that have been provided by Business Standard covering all the recommendations. Number one is there should be at least 6 directors on the board of a listed company. So number one important here is listed company. It's talking about only listed and not unlisted companies. Listed company means company which is listed on the stock exchange, and at least 6 directors on the board of a particular listed company. The appointment of at least one woman independent director in every listed company, number two. Next is a higher frequency of board meetings. So board meetings should have a higher frequency. We'll be talking about the specific frequency as well, which has been recommended by the reform panel. The separation of the roles of chairman and managing director. This is very important. This is going to have a huge impact on the way companies are run at the moment. A formal framework for sharing sensitive information between the board and the entities that were not part of the board. A formal framework has to be created. At least 50% independent directors in all listed companies. This is going to be very important. Next is the minimum number of board members from 3 to 6 to be raised from 3 to 6, and the frequency of board meetings to a minimum of 5 from 4 a year. So frequency has to be minimum 5 from 4 and minimum number of board members 6 now. Separation of the roles of chairperson and the CEO. So first was separation of the role of managing director and chairman, and second is separation of the role of chairperson and CEO and managing director for listed companies with public shareholding over more than 40% by April 2020. So this date is also important, more than 40% by April 2020, and extended to all companies whether listed or unlisted by April 2022. Special resolution in case where a single executive salary exceeds rupees 5 crore or 2.5% of net profits. So special resolution in case of single executive salary. So if the salary exceeds rupees 5 crore, then a special resolution has to be passed. The next one is entity will be termed as a material subsidiary if its income or net worth exceeds 10% up from the current 20%. So it's a material subsidiary if its net worth, so this is a holding company, these are three subsidiaries companies. If this subsidiary company holds more than 10% in this holding company, then it becomes a material subsidy. And the material subsidy, as soon as it is declared as a material subsidiary, the rules and regulations change for that particular subsidiary of the consolidated income. This is not important. The government should consider consolidating its ownership and monitoring of PSUs into independent holding entities. So it is also talking about PSUs, and therefore it is important for both next year as well as this year's interview. So this becomes very important. Let's look at the pictures now, which cover all the recommendations, and these all recommendations are going to be very important because they can ask even non-material recommendations as well in the examination. Minimum number of directors 6, we've already discussed this. Minimum number of independent directors increased from a third to a half, 50%, we've already discussed this. At least one woman independent director. Ratification by shareholders if a director fails to attend at least half of the board meetings. This is important. Disclosure of competencies or expertise of directors. So whatever expertise the directors hold, they should be disclosed in the annual meetings that are held. Special resolution for appointment of non-executive directors with age over 75 years. This is very important, and this is going to have an impact on Tata because Ratan Tata's age is more than 75 years. Minimum number of board meetings in a year increased from 4 to 5. Presence of at least one independent director at every board meeting. This is important. Separation of role of chairperson and CEO or MD for listed companies. On independent directors, checks and balances to ensure independence of independent directors. Prescription of minimum compensation and sitting fee. So the minimum compensation sitting fee is to be provided to independent directors compulsorily. Detailed reason for resignation. If a independent director resigns, then a detailed reason is to be provided. Why? The reason for this is because if an independent director is resigning, this means that something is wrong with the company or something wrong has gone into the company, and therefore that person, instead of blowing the whistle and instead of taking certain action, he or she is resigning in order to get out of the situation himself. insurance to protect from significant responsibilities and liabilities, induction and training programs, alternate director not permitted, not important, appointment of a lead independent director. So a lead independent director has to be appointed who is going to lead all the independent directors. Next is improvement in accounting and audit standards. What are the recommendations? Quantification of audit qualifications to be mandatory. Auditor should have a right to obtain independent external opinion. So they can also obtain independent external opinions now. More quarterly disclosures on consolidated basis, not important. Reason for resignation of auditors, this is very important. So reason now has to be provided for resignation of auditors. Audit quality indicators to be made public to increase transparency. So these quality indicators were not public before this, they now have to be made public. Disclose credentials and fees for appointment of auditors, this is very important. Ind AS implementation for all entities including banks, NBFCs and insurance companies, this is very very important. Ind AS implementation is going to become compulsory after these recommendations are accepted. Power to SEBI to act against auditors, this was not available before. More power to ICAI, regulator of auditors, this is also important. Onboard committees, minimum number of audit committee meetings to be increased to 5 every year. So this has been increased as per the recommendation, this should be increased to 5 every year for audit committee specially. Meeting of all other board committees at least once a year. So audit committee 5 and other committees 1. Audit committee to scrutinize the end utilization of funds. Committee recommends the requirements of having at least 2/3 of independent directors on nomination and remuneration committee. This is also very important, especially for the exam. Greater role of NRC, including setting and compensation of KMCs, nomination and remuneration committee, not very important. Presence of one independent director compulsory for quorum. If you are checking the quorum, then an independent director has to be there. Requirement of risk management committee extended to top 500 companies amid growing cyber threats. So this is important because risk management is a part of the syllabus. So risk management companies to become a part of all these companies which are top 500 companies and because of growing cyber threat. Cap on number of committees of for each member, this is not important. On related party transactions, this is also important. Formal framework for sharing of sensitive information with non-board members. Creation of designated person for sharing such info, not very important. Cap on remuneration of promoter directors, so this is important. Who are promoter directors? Directors who were promoters of the company, and who are promoters of the company who were existent or who were involved when the company was created. So this company was created in the year 2001. So the people who were involved in creation of this company or who became a part of the capital structure during creation of this company are promoters, and then they turn into directors. So remuneration of these promoter directors have to be capped because these are the promoters, these were there on the company, and therefore it's important that there is a cap on the remuneration that they take from the company. RPT is to be disclosed once in every 6 months. So all the related party transactions which happen between a holding and subsidiaries or different companies, holding companies who are related in one or the other way, they have to be disclosed every 6 months. Special resolution if royalty or brand payments exceed 5% of turnover. So this is related to promoters as well. So all the promoters who are taking royalties from their companies, from their own companies on some or the other basis, or brand payments from their own company, it should not increase 5% of the turnover, and if it does, then a special resolution by the shareholders has to be passed. On public sector undertakings, this is going to be very very important. Independent of PSUs from administrative machinery, they have given the timeline April 2020. Consolidation of government stake in listed PSUs under holding entity structure. So a holding entity has to be created which should be taking care of administration of PSUs, and the government should not directly be involved. Presently what happens is government is directly involved in all these PSUs administration and control. There should be a holding company which would control these PSUs or regulate these PSUs, and this holding company is going to be liable or responsible to the government. But because it is going to be more specialized, because it is going to be more professional in nature in its working, therefore PSUs are going to have a better future. Setting up of independent board with diversified skill sets, this is not very important. Greater investor participation, remove the boundaries of physical meetings by use of technology, not very important, already being going on. AGM to be conducted within 5 months from end of financial year. So it used to be 6 months, now they've reduced it to 5 months as per the recommendation. Live webcast, not very important. SEBI to introduce common stewardship code, not very important. Stewardship code to cover aspects such as better monitoring of investee companies, not very important. Voting rights on treasury stock to be withdrawn, not very important again. Next one is on disclosure and transparency. Soft copy of annual reports to be provided so that it becomes more accessible. Mobile numbers and email addresses compulsory for all DMAT accounts. This is very important, especially for finance. Linking of all DMAT accounts with Aadhaar, again very very important. Details of ADR, American Depository Receipts, Global Depository Receipts holders with 1% shareholding, this should be provided. Updated list of all credit ratings to be made available at one place for each company, very very important in order to understand the credit rating of a particular company over a long period of time. On disclosure, all disclosures in searchable formats, common filing platform to be devised by exchange is not very important. Disclosures of significant changes in key financial indicators, not very important. Disclosures of basis of valuation and not very important. Capacity building at SEBI, increased staff strength at SEBI to improve monitoring and enforcement, this can be asked. A revolving door policy between SEBI and private sector. We don't know what exactly is the meaning of revolving door policy, so this is going to be very very important. Greater coordination between SEBI and Ministry of Consumer Corporate Affairs, not very important here because no specifics provided in this particular article. Protection of whistleblower, grant of leniency and protection against victimization to whistleblowers. Let's see what provisions are made related to this, which is going to be very very important. So this is all about current affairs for 6th October. We have focused specifically on the committee created by SEBI because the rules and because the recommendations provided by Uday Kotak committee are very very important for the examination. Tomorrow we are going to talk about current affairs for 7th October.